Corus has by now started teasing a new watch, a new device, something going by the teaser image, mountains related, but there's still the Apex, their premium multisport watch, which has been out for a little while, which, as you might have noticed, I have been putting through its paces quite a bit in the mountains, which I didn't publish on, in Florence, at the Vienna City Marathon, and most recently at the Prague Marathon. We still should have a look at its basic operations, and that's what we're going to do immediately. So, first off, right now, let's have a look at the basic operation in watch mode, and then we'll go in another post, in another video, at the training modes, of course. In the Corus Apex, we have a watch which has, first of all, sapphire glass, which is really nice to have, especially on a $300 watch, so not one which is so outrageously expensive as many recently, and yet looks for that quality, so you can't scratch it. The 46mm version, the bigger one I have here, has of course a bigger battery, longer battery life, and a titanium alloy bezel. The smaller 42mm version has less battery and still a ceramic bezel, so very nice as well. We have the charging port here, we have the heart rate sensor. It's all quite flat, pretty nice. I was actually expecting some sweat to maybe get into the charging port there, into the connector piece, and to affect it negatively, but it has not done that at all. We have quick release 22mm straps here, a silicone band which is very bendy, pretty comfortable even though it looks a bit plasticky, like it could get uncomfortable. It is not very breathable, but I've not seen any issues because of that. We have of course the main input via what Corus is calling their digital knob, which is both a sort of scroll wheel and a button, and we have a button. We have a transflective display, as they have become pretty popular recently, meaning that in bad light conditions it can get rather dull and not so easy to read, which all of the recent displays like this do. I mean, same thing here, for example, on the Suunto 9. With backlight, it is pretty good. Here you also see the auto lock active. The auto lock is a feature which you can, of course, set up or disable, which means that 2 minutes after the last button push, the watch is going to lock itself and you need to hold to unlock. Or actually, for some strange reason, the lower button unlocks automatically. Well, lower button is a back button, and also to change the one extra data field which is being displayed on the watch face. So in this case, for example, the floors climbed in the middle, the date and the battery, as well as the steps of the day. It is very usual for the Corus watch faces to have calories and active time as the main displays. But there are, of course, other watch faces as well. We will have a look at them, but it actually makes the most sense, I think, to have a look at the watch faces when we look at the app, because the watch stores 5 different watch faces and another 12 are available, currently at least, on the app. If you want one of the 5, well, if you want one among the 5 which is not on your watch already, then you need to replace one which is on the watch. It's a bit complicated maybe, or it sounds complicated. It isn't really. I guess it saves some memory on the watch, some space there, and it's, well, an unusual way of doing that, I find, but one I find to be perfectly fine. So here, for example, different watch face where you have again calories and active time. You have the date, you have the time, and you have steps or floors climbed or battery level. Yeah, we can change that however we want, of course. So just scrolling down with the digital knob, we get 1 down to the active time during the day and the floors climbed and pushing once to the calories and the steps taken during the day. Next up we get, actually first of all usually this, the heart rate graph for the last 6 hours and the current heart rate shown up here, as well as the heart rate limits we had and the real-time heart rate. Now the heart rate sensor is or was on and was searching for my heart rate. We get another one down, the barometric pressure, air pressure profile for the last 6 hours and the current barometric pressure. Next up we have here the altitude. Elevation can be set up via GPS or entered manually. It's also with a graph of the last 6 hours and the current one. And of course switches, barometric air pressure or altitude switches depending on motion automatically. There's also the temperature, which as usual is of course affected by your body temperature, so you need to take the watch off to get the actual temperature where you are, or it helps knowing the temperature during swimming because the water temperature will affect the watch much more than your body temperature, so then it also works. We have compass here, digital compass, also showing the time it currently is, and there's a second screen where the GPS location, the actual geographical coordinates would be added, but of course this activates GPS, so first of all you'd have to get a GPS fix. And there are notifications, it always shows the last one, and if you push you can actually go through, and as you can see I have been having a discussion, a conversation with the CEO of Coros actually. Yeah, that's it for the main things here. Next up, let's have a look at the menu. So, if we just push the digital knob, we get to the sports modes for one. Currently, there are not so many, but there is run, there is indoor run, there is bike, indoor bike, pool swim or open water, as well as a triathlon mode, which combines bike, run, swim. There is also here the AI trainer. This actually gets into how well Coros says that the Apex is helping you in your training. For example, it shows here your stamina, so how recovered you are basically, and if you are fully recovered or how much time is needed to the recovery, as well as the logbook. Of course, logbook belongs to the training, so we should have more of a look at it maybe there. But here, for example, is the Prague Marathon data. And here as well, you find the aerobic and anaerobic training effect being displayed, which is also a bit of this training advice-giving function of the Apex. We also have the system menu entry here, which offers quite a bit. This system thing has the watch face and theme color setting, which we have quickly seen before. So now I have these watch faces stored to the watch memory, so I can switch between those. Several of them also offer different colors, which can be chosen here. And push to use it. Same thing as before. We also have the option here to pair the phone, to get the app paired with the watch, of course. We have the general menu, which offers quite a bit. We have Do Not Disturb mode, which we can turn on or off here. We have accessories menu entries, so we can broadcast our heart rate. We can look at the edit list, where I currently have no device. The Polar H10 works, at least by now, really well, for example. And we have the option to add an ANT Plus device. Bluetooth here is used only for the connection to the phone, to the app. ANT Plus is being used for devices. This is something that had confused me, I must admit. Alarms which have been set up are stored here, at least a certain amount of them. I don't actually know how many, and can be turned back on easily or edited. Or we can add a new alarm. So we set up when we want it to ring. So choose via the scroll wheel. Sometimes this takes a bit of a time. And set if it should be only once, so the next time this time comes around, which we set up, or every day, or custom. Custom is on certain days, so for example, we could set up a weekend alarm to be on Saturday and Sunday. When an alarm is set up, is set to on, the watch shows when this will ring next, and we get it in the list, shown as active. We did not yet have a look inside the general menu. In the general menu, we can, let's start rather at the top, set up which wrist hand where we are wearing the watch, on the right side or on the left side. We can set up the gesture backlight to be automatically between those times. So between those times when you lift up your wrist with the watch, the backlight will automatically turn on. You can have that active always, or of course you can turn it off. We can choose for the digital knob which direction it should work. We can set up vibration and tones. This is quite important because the vibration and tones has the vibration all off, all on, or for keys off. So keys being the buttons, the key tones. So if it's on, then we get a beep with the buttons. Message and call tones on or off, alarm tones on or off. With off, we have a vibration only alarm. With on, we also get alarmed sounds and activity alert tones as well, on or off. There is the auto lock I mentioned. This auto lock is only for the watch mode, though for sports, there is an extra setting for auto lock during sports. We can of course set up units for metric or imperial. We can set our date and time, so set up the 24-hour format, the auto-sync with the app, that is, which time zone we are in, or just manually set the time. There are languages available. Languages available now are English, are simplified Chinese, traditional Chinese, Deutsch, German, Espanol, Spanish, and Francais. French. We can set up the elevation either by entering it manually or using GPS. We can get to the compass calibration here. And whoops, this is the device info. So the ideas and hardware versions. We can reset everything to factory settings, and we can, to save battery in transit or something, turn off the device. Then it gets turned on again here with the confirm, with the digital knob button. Yeah, that's these basics, but there's one more thing, which is that the back button also leads to a quick menu when you hold it pushed for a bit. Here we get a quick access to the watch face. Quick access to the alarm settings, quick access to do not disturb, to turn it on. We get quick access to the menu of settings. There is a timer here. So you can set up how you want it, or it also stores once you have set up already. Can be paused, can be restarted. Now it's vibrating. There. That was all via vibrating, since I have it set up like that, not for alarm tones. Back again. We also have here a stopwatch. Stopwatch also supports laps. And it supports quite a few laps. And you can scroll through the list of the laps. Afterwards, you can still scroll through the list of laps. Or you can turn it back on or reset it. We have access quickly to the compass here as well, and that now is it.